Sapolala Pagata Mokhosi, and all the members who have come for an Nazi and Swanning Kwekasha Sikul. President Setetile Nomama Wokaya, Waniga Amazu and Kutas. So the program here to is about Kuchani Kaku, Siza Kulanji Kulan Beni, Vesibeni.
And the sons and daughters
raise the flag,
raise the flag of freedom
on the hills,
on the hills and valleys.
How sorry we are to have lost a fine soldier like General Mokhosi. He was destined for great and big things in our South African National Defence Force. He had served the country with great distinction as a brave and gallant soldier who was prepared to lay down his own life as we were fighting for freedom. He was prepared to defend the people of South Africa as we were fighting for freedom, for that is what soldiers of Mkhonto we Sizwe had sworn to do. It's very rare to find committed people like General Mokhosi who had taken a vow that even if I die, so long as the people of South Africa can be free, I will have served my purpose in life. You don't come across people like that easily. And even after freedom, for which you've contributed so much, quite often we talk about the big names of people who contributed, who did this and this and that. We don't talk about the people who actually did most of the work and were prepared to even die for what we have achieved. So today I pay tribute to him in front of his family, in front of his children, and say that he struck me as a person who was so focused, so committed to all that is good for South Africa. When we informed him that we were promoting him to become the chief of the army, he accepted it with humility. It was not like a person who stand up and jump for joy. He accepted it with great humility and said that he is always prepared to serve, always prepared to serve his country. And whatever task he is given, he assured us that he would execute to the best of his ability.